Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, we invite you to take a deep breath. Sit back, relax, and enjoy the Thomas Ewing Junior High Spring Concert. Enjoy the show.
Zum Golly Golly is a traditional Hebrew song relating to the formation of the State of Israel, originating sometime around its creation in 1948. The pioneers referred to in this song were the Jewish settlers who built the new Israel. Years ago, this chant was sung by people while working together. The song leads itself well to digging or any other task requiring a steady beat.
The musical Rent opened on Broadway on April 29, 1996. It is loosely based on Giacomo Puccini's opera La Boheme, the tragic tale of four impoverished artists living in Paris in the 1890s. In Rent, the setting is Lower East Side of New York City during the 1990s. Act Two opens with the company number, Seasons of Love. In the life of feast or famine, it is certainly understandable to ask, how do you measure a year?
Thank you. and truth that she learned during times that he cried and bridges he burned.
For the way that she died, it's time now.
The traditional spiritual Elijah Rock has its roots in African American heritage, but its original author is unknown. Handed down through generations, it emerged as a popular choral arrangement by Jester Harrison in the 1960s. Since then, it has been arranged by several well-known composers, including the arrangement by Roger Emerson you will hear next. The title of the next song, Geronimo, is a reference to the famous Apache military leader Geronimo. and the custom of yelling his name before doing a courageous act. It is also a reference to the 11th Doctor's quote, Geronimo, in the popular sci-fi British drama, Doctor Who.
Song used in Cameroon, West Africa. The song was collected by Elaine Hansen, a missionary of the Evangelical Lutheran Church in America who spent 11 years in Cameroon. This particular group used French as their common language, hence the French verse you will hear at the beginning.
Thank you. The next three pieces we sing tonight were performed at the Ohio Music Educators Association Large Group Contest. We received a rating of 1 from the judges, which is the highest rating, and had a great learning experience as we had a clinic with one of the judges following the performance. We were also able to hear other junior high choirs from the area perform as well. This Latin piece, Non Nobis Domine, is translated, "Not unto us, O Lord, but to your name give the glory."
Describes finding a joyful song to sing and to change our mood into gladness in our singing. Mrs. Lane asked the choir to respond with, "What do you find joy in?" There were a variety of answers, some of which included donuts, babies, tacos, Jesus, and singing in choir. We hope you find joy as you listen to this song.
Thank you. arrangement of Stephen Foster's American minstrel song, O Susanna. This song was performed in an ice cream parlor in 1847 and was published in 1848.
I just want to talk for a minute about how amazing this year has been. It's been a lot of work, but if you saw the kids singing the first day of school to now, it's amazing the progress that they have made throughout the year, and I'm very proud of them. I'm also proud of this group of eighth graders up here. This is the first group that I've ever taken to OMEA contest, and so they knew how stressed I was, and they really brought it, and I was so excited, and I know they were too. And I'm really gonna miss them next year. And I think Mrs. McCoy is out in the audience somewhere. Yeah, there she is, okay. So she's gonna get a good group next year. And speaking of Mrs. McCoy, I hear that there's a birthday today. And so we're gonna do a little wish you happy birthday with the eighth grade's gonna sing. Her concerts, her and Mr. McCoy at the high school, and so many of these students will be going on there next year, and I always look forward to going to at least one of the concerts every year to see them and see how they've grown and progressed. As the seventh graders are coming up, I also want to talk a little bit about them, and as you can see, there are 91 up here, just of the seventh graders, and again, it's a challenge, especially in the seventh grade year, because those boys' voices are going every which way, and they have a tough job because, in my opinion, it's like learning a foreign language because your voice completely changes and you have to learn how to use it all over again. And so we work hard at that, and I'm so proud of all the progress that they have made. And I look forward to all of them, or most of them, seeing them next year. And let's see, one more thing. Oh, yes. I want to give a shout out to my husband, Mr. Lane, because he is always at my right hand playing and videoing and everything else that could possibly be done in the background. And I also want to pay special thanks to Mr. JT Burcham, who is running the sound and has done a great job of getting everything I need today, and Fairfield Christian Academy and Church for providing this space tonight. So please thank all of them.
According to the composer, Jim Papalis, this piece was written with the intention to encourage the individual and the group to strive together towards a goal and to reflect on the inner strength that lies in all us. Together, we will stand side by side with our dreams. We will sing. We will sing for freedom when we sing with our hearts.
Again for coming.